Welcome to DWBIADDA channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Hello friends. In today's video, we will be discussing about passing secrets as environment variables in the Kubernetes cluster. So first of all, what are secrets? So Kubernetes secret objects let you store and manage sensitive information such as password, authorization token, and SSH keys. So secrets is basically an object or a service provided by the Kubernetes to store and manage the sensitive information. Now putting this information in a secret is safer and more flexible than putting it verbatim in a pod lifecycle definition or in a container image. Now whenever we are saving our password or our keys somewhere, we always make sure that they are secure in a manner, and using the secret service which the Kubernetes provide is much more flexible and much more secure than saving the same credentials or same password, authorization token, or SSH keys in the container images. Now talking about secrets, there are two types of secrets. So first is the built-in secrets. Now the Kubernetes automatically creates secrets which contains credentials for accessing the API, and it automatically modifies your pods to use this type of secrets. So what we can do with the Kubernetes is that we can simply automatically create the secrets within which contains the credentials, and we can access the API using those credentials which is present inside the pods. And also the automatic creation and use of API credentials can be disabled or overridden if desired. So if we want, we can simply disable or enable the creation of these API credentials. Now, but for that we need to have a secure access to this API server. And the other thing which we can do regarding secrets is that we can also create our own secrets. So the kubectl create secret command packages these files into a secret and create the object on API server. Now using the kubectl command, we can save the secrets on our desired location. Now basically this is to protect the secret from being exposed accidentally to an onlooker or from being stored in a terminal log. So the basic ideology behind creating our own secret is to protect it from a third person, so that the third person cannot access that secret and we only know where the secret is present inside the pod. Now let's jump into the practical. So here we have an Ubuntu instance which has already installed a Kubernetes master cluster. Now if some pods needs to access a database, the username and password that the pod should use is in the files .username.txt and .password.txt on the machine. Now for that we can simply use the command, but before we should log in as a root user. We have successfully logged in as a root user. Now we will copy this command to store the username and to store the password. Now what we will do is the kubectl will create the secret command packages and packages this file into a secret object on the API server. So we will use this command kubectl create secret generic db users. So as you can see, the secret DB user pass has been created, which can be used by the API server in the future. Now to check the status of the service, we can simply use the command kubectl get secrets. So here we can see that a default token along with the DB user pass has been created. Now if you want to check the services running on this, we can simply use this command So if we use the describe command, we can have the name of the secret, along with that the password and username with the byte information, that how many bytes are contained in that file. Now if you want to create a secret manually to store two strings in a secret using the data field, we convert them to base 64, and to convert them to base 64 we use the command echo and after that base 64. So as you can see, this has been converted into base 64, and the same we will use for the password. Now after conversion into base 64, what we will do is we will create a secret file, which is a secret.yml file. Now this file is the creation of this file is mandatory because the API servers will run according to the configuration present inside this file. So we will paste this configuration and we will save this file. So we have successfully configured the YAML file. After that we will use this command. Okay, there has been some error parsing the line, so we will check into that error. So we'll again check the file. So what we will do right here is that we will try removing the password. And the username. So we remove the password and the username because we have already converted them into base 64 values. Now if we want to decode the secret file which we have created, we will simply use the command kubectl get secret mysecret-o-yml. So what this file will do is it will fetch the secret file we just created, and it will show us the values along with the link and the UID of the secret file. So friends, in today's video we learned how to pass the secrets as environment variables and how we can use these secrets in order to configure our Kubernetes cluster and API server, and using these secret values we can simply access the API servers on the Kubernetes cluster. So that was all for today's video. Thank you.